Welcome to all. Today we are going to discuss about the operations management, one of our core paper in our curriculum. Before going to the discussion, let us focus on the two words, operations and management. Operations, inputs are converted into outputs. A raw material which is going to convert into the output is called the operations. For example, we decide to produce a cement. We are having a cement factory. What will we do? We have to produce the cement. We need the plant, the equipment, the machineries, labor force, and of course the raw materials, the ingredients which is needed to produce the cement, like the sand, the limestone, gypsum, phosphate, some other chemicals which we need to produce the cement. We work on the input materials with the help of the plant, machinery, and of course the labor force, and finally we can get a cement. So this is the basic, a fundamental definition for the operation, the conversion of raw material into the finished product. And there is another word, management. Management is nothing but doing conversions, the operation conversions or transformation process in an effective and efficient manner. How efficiently we are going to work with our available resources is called the management. By this we can conclude, excuse me ma'am, we can come to the definition. Operations management is concerned with converting materials and labor into goods and services as efficiently as possible to maximize the profit of an organization. Okay, and of course we discuss about the physical transformation of input material into output material. There is another kind of operations too, the services operations. In today's scenario, the services operations like hospital operations, banking operations, these kind of operations are service operations we are having in our hand. For example, we got ailment. What will we do? We go for an hospital. What will they do? They treat us by their equipments, medicines, and their supportive laborers. So then we can come to our home with a smiling face. So that is also a operations, but that is service operations. We will discuss this kind of operations in the another subject, services marketing. In operations management, it mainly focuses on the physical conversion, the production of the material, the production of raw material into the final good, the physical product we discuss. In the operations management, there are four things the operation manager will have to focus. Number one, quality. How much our goods should be in a good manner. How quality, what is the quality we need to produce? What is our capacity, what is our capability, our resources, available resources to produce a quality good, he must focus. Then the quantity, how much our product is demanded in the market, or how much we agree to give to our purchasers, to our customers, how much we agree. For example, we agreed our customer to giving 500 units of product. We have to give that 500 units of product. So the quantity, the manager, the operations manager should keep in their mind. Then timely delivery, the time duration which we promise to our customers. When the customers needs our product, for example 3 months or 6 months, in that time period we have to give the material, the consignment to the customers. Then competitive price. For this we have to produce our goods in a competitive cost. Minimum cost and the maximum, how maximum we can produce, that's one. Okay, by these lines we come to the conclusion that operation management is a conversion of input material into output material. There are four concepts the manager should have in their mind: the quality, quantity, time, and the price, competitive price. This is the overview of our curriculum, what we are having in our curriculum, our subjects list: plant location, plant layout and production system, material management, plant maintenance, and quality control. One by one we are having in our paper, the syllabus we are having in our curriculum. Number one, the plant location. Plant location is nothing but where our plant is located. Plant location refers to the choice of region and the selection of a particular site for setting up a business or factory. Where? For this selection, we must keep in mind is whether we are going to install our plant in a rural area, semi-urban area, or in the urban area. Why? There are some of the elements, some of the factors to be considered while selecting the location. Likewise, it should be the nearness to the market, then the availability of raw material, then the government policies, procedures. Likewise, there are many factors that decide the location of the plant. Then the plant layout, physical arrangement of equipment and facilities within a plant. How we are going to arrange our equipments, our machineries, or how efficiently we arrange our materials. Then production system, the methods, procedures, or arrangements which includes all functions required to accumulate the inputs and deliver the marketable output. The production system, all kind of production does not need a same kind of production system. For example, if we are doing a textile or garment in the garment manufacturing, we cannot produce a yarn with one machine. We have to install a sequence of machineries one by one. One department, one machinery next to the another machinery. Likewise, we have to arrange. In this unit, we will discuss the production system and the plant layout. And the materials management, it is concerned with planning, organizing, and controlling the flow of materials from their initial purchase through internal operations to the service point through distribution. How we are going to manage our materials, or raw materials or equipments elsewhere. Then plant maintenance. Every organization have to maintain their plant. It will face them difficulties or repairs or some other defects. Functions of manufacturing management, that is concerned with day-to-day problem of keeping the physical plant in good operating condition. We have to maintain our machineries, we have to maintain our laborers, we have to maintain such other things. Then finally, the quality control is our objective, is going, or we are getting our objectives well. Then we have to monitor this, or whether our production system is going well, our production is going well. Then procedures, what are the procedures we are having in while producing the products. Then the effectiveness of the production. Thank you.